Hey, everybody. Welcome back. I'm Tom Thelen, author of Victim Proof. And today I'm interviewing another bullying author, Dr. Mildred Peyton. Dr. Peyton recently completed her dissertation on the subject of bullying, and she has a new book called A Bully on the School Bus. Dr. Peyton, welcome to the show.
Hi, Tom. Thanks for having me here.
Yeah, I'm really excited for you to be on the show. I think your book will be great for families to read, especially with those younger elementary age kids, the same age of kids my wife and have, and you and your husband, you have elementary age kids. Tell us about that new book.
All right. Well, my new book right here, My Baby, this book means a lot to me. You know, it was inspired by my dissertation. Once I completed my study, I was just so... I was just so appreciative of the parents that took the time to participate in my study and just the rich information that I gathered. And I just felt the need to just keep going forward and talk more about this topic. So I hope that I can just continue to just, you know, keep the topic alive and just build more awareness around this topic.
Well, you're already doing that. So great job.
Thank you.
Yeah. Well, today on the show, I know you put together some points of advice for parents. And I wanted to get right into your top three points that you have for how you can help parents who have a child who's dealing with bullying. Let's get right to it. What's your advice for these parents?
Definitely. My number one advice would be, you know, always be in tune with your child's behavior, their daily activities. Have a very close connection with your child. So therefore, if there's something going on, you'll be able to detect or identify those red flags. You want to have that rapport with your child and just in a sense, just so that you are aware of what's going on in school or what's going on at home and just in general, what's going on with them emotionally. So that's my number one advice. Just be and just have a close connection with your child. Just be in tune with their emotions and their daily activities.
Oh, big time. I love that idea of digging deeper. I mean, it's kind of like when we pick up our kids from school, sometimes we ask them, my son in particular, he's famous for the, it was good. How was your day? And he just says, oh, it was good. Well, aren't you going to tell us about your day?
Right.
I just did. Yeah. It was good. What more do you want to know?
Yeah, with the
you
kids,
have to dig a little deeper.
That's right. We got to probe. We got to dig deeper and just say, you know, well, what made your day good? Why was it bad? Or, you know, just ask more questions just to get a better sense of, you know, how their day was.
Yeah, absolutely. And even more so when some of those red flags show up and the kid didn't have a good day. How would you encourage the parents to dig deeper if the kid, if they said they had a bullying incident at school, what would be the initial response for a parent?
The initial response, I would say, you definitely, once your child mentioned those, utter those words, you definitely want to contact the school. You might want to reach out to the teacher, the principal, or whomever your child basically feels comfortable with in the school. You will take the initiation to speak with those persons and just see what's going on and see if, in fact, if it's something that... you know, needs to be addressed or if it's just like a one-time incident. But I say as a parent, you want to take the initiative and just reach out to the school for sure.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, parents don't always know what are their avenues for reaching out to the school and are there sort of official and unofficial ways that they can connect with the school. And I think that brings us right into your point two of your advice here.
Yes. You know, sometimes parents are not aware of who to reach out to besides a teacher. There are school counselors, there are school social workers. So, you know, you can also tap into those other areas when we're talking about other school personnel. And one thing I would strongly recommend that parents also do when as they are trying to, you know, understand what's going on, they should also request to fill out a bullying incident form. There are forms available in the schools, and it's you know, they're there for parents to use and for students to also use. And I think that if parents know that, you know, there are other ways to go about reporting it, they probably won't feel as hopeless or lost or, you know, they'll have more of a sense of direction, knowing that, okay, these are the different areas or these are the different ways I can tackle reporting my child's incident.
Well, I remember we were talking earlier and you said, you know, some parents don't even know that there's a bullying form. And then those that find out about it, there were times in your research where the schools, they kind of discouraged the parent from even filling it out. What does a parent do when they get that kind of pushback? Like, oh, you know, you don't have to fill out the form.
Well, you know, that definitely creates a lot of frustration and anger for the parents at times. But when that happens, I will say, you know, you can step it up a notch. You can either seek further, you know, support from the Board of Education, the superintendent, or even outside our resources in the communities. There are youth programs, religious groups, counseling. There are anti-bullying websites that, you know, can give you a lot of resources and tips as to how to handle the problem. So, you know, there is hope. There is some sort of relief to know that, okay, if the schools are not giving me the responses or feedback that I need, there you can also, again, explore other areas outside of the school and see how they can better help you, because I strongly believe that, you know, there's more than one way to go about, you know, getting your problem solved. So,
yeah, definitely. Absolutely. Well, your family and our family, we have kids in early to middle elementary age right now. And we also talked about the importance of extracurricular activities, where if our kid is having a hard time succeeding socially at school, there are other community groups or sports teams or, you know, choirs or whatever they could get in where they could experience some success socially that they might not be getting at school. That could help build some of the self-esteem. Tell me more about that idea.
Absolutely. You know, when you have a child that's experiencing bullying, one way to kind of help them out is to, like you said, just get them involved in other groups, you know, where they'll feel like, you know, like they're, that they're valuable, that they have something to offer, and a place that can boost their self-esteem. And that's definitely being around a group of positive, you know, like-minded peers like themselves. And I think just in the social environment itself can play a great role as to how your child may handle bullying when they're faced with it, and how they treat others. So by doing that, by placing your child in those type of groups or seeking outside help, you're empowering your child. You know, you're showing them how to be resilient. You're telling them that they don't have to settle to being a victim of bullying. You know, yes, they you know, might get bullied, but they don't have to accept it. So yes, we definitely want to empower children. And one way to do that is to get them involved in outside groups where they feel safe and secure.
And absolutely. What about resources that are still inside the school? You know, how does a parent get their child connected to like a school counselor? Maybe the parent says, oh, they won't talk to me about it, but I know they're going through something. How would you get that kid connected to deeper services within the school itself?
You know, as a parent, you know, it's my job to basically, you know, do the best I can do for my child to make sure that, you know, that they're going to be at a point where they feel safe and everyone has a, you know, peace of mind. So I would definitely continue to elevate. You know, you reach out to the coach, the music teacher, whoever you can, whoever attention that you can grab. Just continue to reach until you get someone to listen to you and someone who's willing to work with you. And also inquire about peer mediation groups. You know, in my study, I realized that, you know, there are previous researchers out there that pretty much concluded that peer mediation groups are very successful. You know, those that are placed in schools can be a great source of outlet for the child who's being bullied. And it gives them, again, a sense of empowerment and unity to be in a place with other, students, you know, who they feel comfortable with. So it's a sense of, you know, just, I guess, again, unity and working together.
And working together being a big key to this whole thing. I know in your research, we talked earlier that you saw a difference between the parents that worked with the schools and the parents who felt pitted against the schools and how much results they got. Tell us about how that went in your research.
Well, the parents that worked with the schools, like in a sense of partnership and just making a collective effort, it did seem that, you know, the issue did subside, that they received the results that they were expecting. You know, I guess the school administrators were more willing to help and listen to the parents when they in fact show that, okay, you know, we're in this together. I'm not attacking you. I'm just saying that this is an issue that's going on in your environment, and what's the best way we can tackle this issue together. So there were greater responses when the parents did approach the school in a more collective manner.
So it makes sense. You know, I'm on your side, we're working together, rather than I can't believe you're not helping my kid and sort of pointing the finger of blame at the school. Right. Oftentimes the school doesn't even realize how bad of an issue it is until you raise the issue again and again, like you said today. Well, before we close out the session, I just want to see what your final words of advice are for parents in the home with their kid. You know, let's say the bullying has gone on for a long time and they've exhausted a lot of what they've seen as the traditional roads to recovery. What can they still do in the home to help their child?
You know, you definitely want to lay a strong foundation. You want that sense of family, of community. You want to show your child that no matter what, you know, no matter how long this takes, we're here to support you. We're going to go through this together. So you want to have that bond and that understanding of, you know, you're not alone. We're in this together, and we're going to work through this. So you know, and by doing that, you're also showing, again, you're empowering your child to believe in their willpower and overcoming this great challenge that they face.
Absolutely. And that's the hope for any family out there, is that together they can get through it. There is another side to bullying. Yeah. Dr. Peyton, thanks for being on the show today. Where can an audience get a copy of your book?
My book is currently available on Amazon online and Barnes & Noble's online. Also, exlibris.com and Create Space. So there's plenty of online bookstores that you can find my book. And, you know, you can also go directly to my website at www.drmildredpeyton.com, and you'll be able to find my book there.
Well, go out there, grab a copy of Dr. Peyton's new book. It's called A Bully on the School Bus. Thanks again for being on the show, Dr. Peyton. And thanks for watching this episode of Victim Proof.